Congressman John Fleming and Michael Turner for reaction to the news. Congressman Turner, let me start with you. Are you chairman of the subcommittee of some of our special forces?
I've got strategic forces.
Strategic forces.
Our nuclear weapons and missile defense and the like. But last night I had the opportunity to join those celebrants in front of the White House, and the energy was incredible. Certainly Americans across the country are responding very positively to the fact that of what this could mean and of this accomplishment.
We've had most people say we should be, it could have an influence on sentiment, and I'm talking not just the markets, but just about being an American for a few days. We've had others that say that this is closure that could be significant. What do you make of it at this point, Congressman Turner?
Well, you know, this is really a search that has spanned three presidencies, with the first attack on the World Trade Center in 1993, the Kenyan and Tunisia bombings of our embassies in 1998, USS Cole in 2000, and then with 2001. So this really is almost a two-decade search, and certainly shows the tenacity of our men and women in uniform, the effects of our intelligence, and the fact that the United States is going to bring terrorists to justice.
And Congressman Fleming, what are your thoughts? Were you or last night? I heard Congressman Turner was actually there. What were you doing when you heard?
Well, I was actually preparing to go to bed and saw the breaking news. None of the members of Congress were notified before this happened, which is good. I appreciate that, because secrecy was very tight on this. But what we saw is that UBL, who cowardly hid behind a woman, was finally disposed of, and this is certainly a great day, a great time. I think that he served as a symbolic leader of the jihadist movement, and I think that this is a signal that this is the beginning of the end of that movement.
Either one of you, and I don't know how we'll decide who tossed first, but what about Pakistan? Are we pleased that they finally gave us an indication of where, I guess we got some intelligence from someone in Pakistan, but it's been 9.5 years, and he was, you know, close to Islamabad in a pretty nice place. I mean, Congressman Fleming, we give them a lot of money. What do you think?
Well, absolutely, and I think it's very clear that there was at least parts of the government and parts of their military that we had to hide this from. We did not notify them, is my understanding, and as well we didn't, because in the past when we have let them know, when we were making a surgical strike, for instance, going in with perhaps boots on the ground, we find that the terrorists have cleared out, and that's not good for our relationship. But I think hopefully now we have a chance to rebuild our relationship, and they'll work in cooperation with us.
You know, Congressman Turner, some of the intelligence, as you alluded to, was reportedly originally obtained through Guantanamo and the questioning in Guantanamo. So what does this say now about that whole situation, and what should we be doing with the prisoners that are there as a result of the success here?
Well, and if that is true, that the information from Guantanamo led us here, I think it certainly is a vindication of the importance of pursuing the individuals that were in Guantanamo, the fact that they are terrorists, that they had information that was actionable and that was important. Also, there's going to be a number of avenues that we're going to be able to pursue as a result of capturing Osama bin Laden. The location he was at is going to be a treasure trove of additional intelligence that hopefully is going to let us understand how he has evaded us, who has been supporting him, and where other terrorists are located that we might also be able to bring to justice.
All right, gentlemen, we appreciate your appearing this morning on what is a certainly a noteworthy day to you both, Congressman.